There's been a lot of people who's been asking me to explain how to use the decryptor that I put in the description of my censor patch mod. I will also be showing you how to patch and censor Fear and Hunger 1. Alright, so first of all, what you will be needing right here is have Fear and Hunger 1 installed. I will show you how to get to this folder. Give me a second. So what you gotta do is you gotta right click your Fear and Hunger game, go to properties and go to local files, go to browse, and you'll see the folder right here. This is the folder of Fear and Hunger 1. Make sure that you backup this folder in case you mess up. Go ahead, right click it, copy it, and make a backup if you want. Alright, now that you know where your Fear and Hunger game is, and you have downloaded the RPG MV decryptor, as well as my mod, you should check out that your Fear and Hunger 1 folder is not decrypted right now. How do you check this out? You go to your www folder, you go into your image folder, then you go into your characters or any kind of folder. You'll see that there's all these RPG MVP files. They are not decrypted right now, so you cannot read them. You cannot see them. If you double click them, nothing happens. Okay, so what we're gonna do is we're gonna decrypt all of this. We're gonna make sure to right click our RPG MV decryptor for Windows or Linux, depending on what you have. You go ahead and extract to RPMV decryptor Win32. Once we get their folder, you might as well make sure to extract Censor Mod. Once you have just two folders decrypted, you're gonna go ahead and open RPG MV decryptor for Windows 32. Go ahead and open the RPG MV decryptor.exe. Either double click it, or if you're not too sure, go ahead and right click and open as administrator. A message is gonna pop up saying, please select the game's directory, the one that contains the main executable. So we're gonna find our folder and we're gonna go all the way and mark it over here, this folder. Exactly. This is the main executable for the game. We're gonna go ahead and click OK. And you will find your folder for Fear and Hunger 1. Make sure to click it, go ahead and click OK. And nothing's gonna happen. Wait for a bit till we get a message. Done, game has been decrypted and an editable file has been created. So we check our Fear and Hunger folder and we will check on www. We see that we have this new item here, but to be able to check that the game is decrypted successfully, go ahead and go into your image folder and go into characters or any other folder, and you'll see that everything has been decrypted. So now the game will be reading from this folder as well as all of these folders, okay? We're gonna go ahead and now do the patching. We go ahead and open my censor patch, which will contain this www folder as well as a readme in case you're lost. We're gonna go ahead and drag it and drop it here. Once it asks us to replace the files, we say yes. After we patch your game, you should maybe, if you want, go ahead and check www, go into image, and maybe check the enemies if they are censored or not. And you'll see images like this, where my censor mod was able to catch this kind of imagery from the game. There's more of it in case you wanna check if there's something I have missed. Please make sure to let me know in this video or in the other video where I uploaded the censor mod. This was done by myself for 3 days. I have received some friends' help, but it's mostly myself, the one who had the idea of censoring everything. Okay, so you're either gonna run the game with the game.exe or you can just run it with the Steam. To be able to tell that a mod has been successfully installed, make sure to check down here and you'll see that it says censored by a dark raccoon. Okay, well, that is all for the video. If you have any comments, make sure to type them down below. And if you like my work, make sure to support me with a like, a subscribe, maybe sharing the video around. Thank you so much for your time, and I will see you in the next one. Oh, by the way, remember to remove these WinRARs, because there's no reason for this cleanup. That should be fine. Hey!